this video isn't so much a Final Cut Pro versus Premiere Pro video. It's more or less, I just made it because I'd heard text responses and in YouTube videos, a lot of Final Cut Pro 10 users had made the accusation that unless you've got, you know, a $1,800 Quadro card from NVIDIA or, you know, dual Xeon system, you know, Premiere Pro's not going to get any real time out of it. And I just want people to know that for this video, I'm using like a sub $1,000 system. What I was going to just do real quick is I do have this in GPU only mode, but just to let people know, as opposed to CPU, it is in GPU. I just have an NVIDIA GT240. Mine's actually got the DDR5 RAM. It's only got 1 gigabyte of video memory as opposed to 2 gigs. And just to kind of give some of you an idea of the horsepower inside of Premiere Pro on a budget system, because this system I got, you can build for well under, I built it for under $1,000. You can build it for well under $1,000 now. So you don't need a, you know, $5,000 computer for a Premiere Pro CS5.5 to play 3 layers of native AVC HD in its, you know, in its native codec. So what I have here is actually 3 layers, and every layer is color corrected, and it's in its highest quality, and I'm not dropping, you know, any frames at all. It's playing back smooth as butter. I'm not sure if you can see the yellow bar across here. That may not come out on YouTube once I load it up to YouTube. But you should see that the yellow bar is there. It's using GPU acceleration as opposed to CPU acceleration. You'll see a little red dot maybe there, depending on how clear this comes out on YouTube. But the transitions with Premiere Pro CS5.5 are not GPU accelerated. They rely on the CPU. There's a few like cross dissolves and stuff that are GPU accelerated, and I don't know if they did that in hopes that, you know, usually you're just using one between two video clips transitions. You're probably not going to use it that much, and maybe they figured that it'd be good to let the CPU do a little bit of the, special effects, you could maybe say. Premiere Pro CS5.5 should be able to edit, you know, single layers of native AVC HD with several filters on it and be able to scrub just fine. You should be able to scrub it just as I'm scrubbing it here. As people can see, it's going forward, backward without it, you know, locking up. Unless, like I said, unless you got a bunch of layers, then you might notice it lock up. But I think Premiere Pro CS5.5 has some pretty good real time to it. Is it possible that Final Cut Pro 10 or Final Cut Pro X has more real time than Premiere Pro does? It's possible that it does. I mean, it's possible I may only be able to get like 3 layers of native AVC HD on the same configured system, whereas you might be able to get 7 or 8. I'm not really sure which one has more real time, which one looks better as far as previews go. I can honestly say Premiere Pro, the previews look really good. They probably do on Final Cut Pro 10 as well, but I guess what I'm saying here is that Final Cut Pro and Premiere both probably have enough, you know, real-time horsepower, I guess you could say, for both of them to edit, you know, multiple layers of native AVC HD, which is a really hard codec to edit with. And whether I get 3 layers and you can get 30 layers should be irrelevant, because on a $1,000 system, you know, Premiere Pro can edit native AVC HD just fine. Maybe I'll only get 3 layers, you might get 30 layers. But you really got to think about how many times you're going to actually try and use 30 layers. And I'm not sure that Final Cut Pro even has more real time. There's some people out there that might even say that they notice they get more real time using Premiere Pro than they do with Final Cut Pro. But whether you're using Avid, Final Cut Pro, or Premiere, all of them should be able to edit native AVC HD, as well as Sony Vegas and the Edius software. You really shouldn't need a $5,000 system to edit native AVC HD using Premiere Pro CS5.5. That's the only reason I really made this video. I'm using it in GPU mode, like I said, right now. I can, you know, scrub the timeline. We can play this. It'll actually even play a transition. This particular transition is a dissolve, so it is GPU enabled. But even like this right here, I still have it in full resolution. And here we come up where it's red. That transition's not even GPU accelerated, just with the CPU. I've got it full resolution. The CPU is powerful enough with Premiere Pro CS 5.5 to play that at highest resolution without dropping frames. So it'll probably, well, it might actually look jerky, but obviously when you're scrubbing, the more you increase the timeline, obviously now this is looking smooth as I'm scrubbing it, as opposed to looking jerky. Obviously with Media Composer Final Cut Pro, I mean, if I shrink down the timeline and I try and do scrubbing, of course it's going to look really jerky, because every little bit that you move the cursor, you're skipping, like, you know, a good 20, 30, 40 frames, whereas when you, you know, bring it out a little bit, yeah, it's going to be a lot smoother scrubbing. So I want people to see right here, you're seeing really smooth scrubbing. If you're just using single layers, you can, like I said, even put a transition on it. It should scrub pretty smooth. Well, here I am in CPU only mode. We've got the color correction, as you can see. The resolution's not as good. I had to drop it down to half resolution in order to play three layers of native AVC HD with color correction on them. I can't do it in CPU only mode at full resolution. So maybe Final Cut Pro and Avid can. I've noticed that with Premiere Pro CS 5.5, I can't do three layers at full resolution relying just strictly on the CPU. But you can build inexpensive computer systems with CUDA-enabled, you know, technology on the PC side for well under $1,000. So like I said, you don't really need a really expensive, you know, computer to edit, you know, with Premiere Pro, you know, native AVC HD. I just don't know how those rumors got started. I mean, if you can't do it on your Mac, there's something configured wrong with it, because this right here is all strictly, you know, CPU only mode. The previews look good enough, I guess, for real-time previews for clients, you know, if they want to do over-the-shoulder editing. It's just, it looks a lot better on here, obviously, if you're at half-resolution editing in strictly CPU-only mode, as opposed to spitting it out that way. I mean, I guess if the client's a good, you know, 7-8 feet away, that'll look just as clean and crisp as this would from, say, like, a foot and a half or 2 feet away.